We have been taking series on intercessory, and today I would like us to see under intercession prayer for the nations. Prayer for the nations. When we are interceding, we need also to know that we need to pray for the nations where God has placed his people, because intercession goes together with the people that were created after the image and the likeness of God himself. And our text this morning will come from the book of Psalms, chapter 2 and verse number 8. Psalms chapter 2 and verse number 8, which says, "Ask for me, and I will give you the nations for your inheritance, and the ends of the earth for your possession." Let me repeat it again. Ask for me, and I will give you the nations for your inheritance, and the ends of the earth for your possession. Now God has a plan for all the nations and for the all people groups that he has created after his own likeness and his own image. And therefore God would like us to pray and intercede in line with the purpose and the mission of our Lord Jesus Christ. Because in the place where we have just read, in the book of Psalm chapter 2 and verse number 8, this was God the Father who was asking for the Son to ask for him, for the nation, so that he gives this nation to the sons as an inheritance and also as possession. And that's why you find Jesus Christ left heaven. He came down here. He was born just through a natural child, the way a child can be born. And therefore, he just came and he was incarnated from the eternal God, and he came here to be born as a child. And I want you to know at this particular point that when Jesus Christ was here on earth, he was 100% human being and he was 100% God. So he had the two natures that were in the oven together, because he was 100% human, he was 100% God. And therefore, God was telling the Son that when you are going down there to the earth for the mission of redeeming even the mankind, what you need to do, ask for me for the inheritance from the nations that you are going to redeem, and therefore they will become your possession. And therefore you find it, the Father tells his Son to ask for the nation for his inheritance, where also the body of Jesus Christ should team together with the Son. We are to join Jesus Christ in asking the Father to make all the people groups on earth God's people through his redemption plan. Jesus' desire is to see the nations worship him, and that is why he commanded us to join him in winning the souls for his kingdom. Before Jesus Christ ascended into the heavens, he left this command together with you and also together with me. And I'm going to quote in the book of Matthew, chapter number 28, verse number 18 to verse number 20. The Bible says this, Matthew 18, 28, and verse number 18 to verse number 30. He says, "Then Jesus came to them." To them here is referring to the disciples of Jesus Christ. "And he said to these disciples, 'All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age." Jesus Christ commanded the disciples before he ascended into the heavens, and he told them to go and make disciples out of every nation. And you find him making disciples, that is evangelism and world evangelization, goes together with intercession. Jesus Christ also, he said in the book of Mark chapter 16 and verse number 15 to verse number 20, in connection of sending us, teaming together with him, this is the body of Jesus Christ, believers, to team together with him so that they can make some also disciples. And that's why in the book of Mark chapter 16, verse number 15 to verse number 20, the Bible says, he said to them, "Go into all the world and preach the gospel to the creation. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, but whoever does not believe will be condemned." Verse number 17 says, and these signs will accompany those who believe. In my name, they will drive out the demons. They will speak in new tongues. They will pick up snakes with their hands. And when they drink deadly poison, it will not hurt them at all. They will place their hands on the sick people and they will get well. After the Lord Jesus had spoken to them, he was taken up into the heaven and he sat at the right hand of God. Verse number 20, it is very important, it says, then the disciples went out and preached everywhere, and the Lord worked with them and confirmed his word by signs that accompanied them. Oh, Jesus Christ left the command with the disciples, and that command we are still following because we too are a disciple of Jesus Christ, to go and make disciples from every nation. And you find you cannot go and dislodge the powers of darkness and to loose the captives which are under the demonic influence and the power and the possession without interfering and interacting with God actually in his prayer. You need to intercede so that you can be able to have power. In the book of Psalms, if you read, and I'm going to quote chapter 67, Psalm 67, we see a prayer for the nation. The psalmist here asks God to make his way known on earth, his salvation among all the nations. And therefore, he says here, in Psalm 67 and verse number 1, may God be gracious to us and help us, and make his face shine on us, so that your ways may be known on earth, your salvation among all the nation. May the God praise be praised, O God. May all the people praise you. May the nations be glad and sing for joy, for you rule your people with equity and guide the nations of the earth. And in verse number 5, he says, may the people praise you. May all the people praise you. The land yield its harvest, God. Oh God, bless us. May God bless us still, so that all the ends of the earth will fear him. All of this is talking about to harvest the souls for the kingdom of God. And intercession is very important, it's very vital when it comes for world evangelization. Therefore, you find the place we have read, it says, you ask God, he was asking God, and we should ask God to govern the people so that they can be glad in singing for joy. He asked God to govern the nation and cause the ends of the earth to fear him. And Jesus actually died for the all people of the earth. And that's why we need to always to team with Jesus Christ so that we can intercede for the people and bring them from the powers of darkness to know God. Because his people are inheritance of Jesus Christ, and his people are also possession of Jesus Christ here on earth. He would want actually us, that is God, to reach out to the people of different groups. Africans, Chinese, American, Indians, and all peoples as his inheritance. We need to join Jesus in asking the King, that is our God, of the nation to reveal himself to the earth. And that's why you find, if you read the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter number 7, and verse number 14, the Bible tells us this word, that is Chronicles, chapter number 7, and verse number 14, it says this, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, and seek my face, and turn from their wicked way, then I will hear from heaven, and I will forgive their sins and heal their land. So you find here, it was during the time when Solomon had just dedicated the temple of the Lord. Because since God called Abraham, there had not been a permanent building for God to come and dwell. Then after Solomon built the temple for God to come and reside in that temple, he responded in verse number 14. And that is where we have just read, how God responded during the dedication of that temple. And therefore, we can analyze these key phrases of in the response to the guidelines of to prayer for the nation. Because the first thing here he says, if my people, and my people here means it's God is instructing his own people, people that are connected with God. When the heavens are shut, God said, and the land invested by diseases, the way also corona has bombarded the entire world and invaded the entire world, even our nation in Kenya. And he says, if destruction will come, And if also we come and become responsible before God, then we need to talk to our God. And God's people should be responsible to talk to Him. And the church can touch God. The church can touch heaven and change here or the earth if we carry out the priestly responsibility. We are God's people and we need to repent our sins for the nation so that the nations will come to God. And we need to intercede for the nation. We need to intercede for our country, Kenya, because it is inclusive in the nations of the world. And where God has put you, you need to intercede for Uganda. You need to intercede for USA. You need to intercede for Australia. You need to intercede for Asian country. Wherever God has planted you as a believer, it is your responsibility for you to intercede for the nation. And even for your own nation where God has put you. And my dear friend, I would like just to finish this point here. And we are going to pray for the nations. Let us pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I want to commit the nations of the world. Because you asked and you said in Psalms chapter number 2 and verse number 8 that you needed to ask for me for the nations and they will become your inheritance. And even the ends of the earth will become your possession. Dear Father God, we pray that you are going to help us so that we can intercede for the nation, so that you can visit us in a very special way. We give you praise, we give you honor, knowing that, dear Father God, you are going to bless us and you are going to bless even our nation Kenya, for in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.